If you've been feeling as though you're just enduring, you're committed to the Lord and you're doing all the things that you normally do, but it's like something's just been subduing you. There's been a dampening down. The vibrancy of your relationship with Him just hasn't been there, and it's been enduring. It's been commitment. This is definitely for you. And perhaps you've been even thinking, yeah, I've just been enduring through this season. The Lord is saying, no, you've been enduring. He's saying it with a positive tone that changes everything. So just encourage you to take on His perspective today. This is in keeping with Romans 5:3, which says, not only so, but we also glory in our sufferings because we know that suffering produces perseverance or enduring. Perseverance produces character, and character hope. So this is for you. It's not a negative, oh, I've been enduring. It's a well done, good and faithful servant. You have been enduring. And out of that endurance develops your character and produces hope. So I encourage you today that you can flip that perspective now and embrace that you're doing well with the Lord, even though you haven't felt vibrant and alive in this time. This particular week has been a real shift for us. And one of the key words in our worship was awaken. And God is lifting that sense of being subdued, of being bland off. And it's time to reawaken and restore and renew that passion and zest for life that you've had in the past with the Lord. So what do we do in that? Well, Dan preached about this when he talked about margin, and this week is really, I think, important to set aside extra margin again to spend time with the Lord. And just as it says in Psalm 100 in verse 4, enter His gates with thanksgiving and His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him and praise His name. So go into your time with the Lord, thanking Him for who He is in your life, and praise Him. And that's the starting point to having this shift take place for you, having, I guess, dreams restored, passions restored, the desires of your heart allowed to be back to life for you. And so we just really want to bless you in that today. And just finally, I just want to read over you something from Colossians 1, which we as a church have sat in this a couple of times in the last couple of months. And I really want to bless you with this again today. And it says, we continually ask God to fill you with the knowledge of His will through all the wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives, so that you may live a life worthy of the Lord and please Him in every way, bearing fruit in every good work, growing in the knowledge of God, being strengthened with all power according to His glorious might, so that you may have great endurance and patience. So bless you, church, as you press in to spending more time with God, creating that margin and letting Him reawaken the passions that you have in life, the zest for life with God in your relationship.